close our eyes in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for your love. Everything that we are, everything that we have is all yours. We love you and we worship you for who you are. And we ask you, Lord, that you descend into this place as we worship you, as we adore you. Every step of faith, every sacrifice, every prayer that's prayed from an honest heart, you alone deserve every breath of worship. And I just wanna say how great you are. Can we sing that song together? Every step of faith. Every step of faith, every sacrifice, every prayer that's prayed from an honest heart. You alone deserve every breath of worship. And I just wanna say how great you are. And just sing and tell the Lord it's all for you. It's all for you. Every song of praise, it's all for you. And every hand that's raised, everything I am, everything I do, it's all for you. Could we stand up to our feet this evening and sing it with joy in our hearts, telling the Lord, it's all for you, Lord. Everything I am, everything I have is all for you.
And every hand that's raised, everything I am,
everything I am, everything I do, it's all for you, it's all for you. We're just gonna sing this beautiful song of surrender. Just this one line I want you to say, it's all for you, it's all for you. Lord, it's all for you, it's all for you. Can you join me in that chorus as we say, it's all for you. Say all for you, all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you, all for you. It's all for you, it's all for you. From your heart, sing it out. All for you. Yes, Lord, I sing it out. It's all. Close our eyes, and could we open our hands unto God? Could we open up our hands unto Him and sing it? It's all for you. Let our hands be raised up to the heavens. Let our voices rise from our heart. Let praise and surrender belong to God. Surrender your life into His hands as you say, it's all for you, Lord. Clapping in the house of the Lord. The psalmist says, clap your hands and shout for joy in the house of the Lord. Enter His courts with thanksgiving and praise unto His name. So let's praise Him tonight from our heart. Are you ready to praise Him? Are you ready to praise Him tonight? Can you look at the friend next to you and ask them, are you ready to praise God tonight? I want you to ask the friend next to you, are you ready to praise God tonight? Step of faith, every sacrifice, every prayer that's prayed from an honest heart, you alone deserve every breath of worship. I just want to say how great you are. Tell them, Lord, it's all for you.
It's all for you, and it's so.
every hand that's raised, everything, everything I am, everything I do, it's all. And say it's all. Let our voices raise. Oh, my life is all. It's all. My job, Lord, it's all for you. My family, it's all for you. My life is all for you. Everything I am, everything I do. It's all for you. It's all for you. Thank you, Jesus, that you are a part of my life. Make a short prayer deep down in your heart and tell the Lord, I need you, Lord. I need you above everything in my life. I have a maker. He formed my heart before even time began. My life was in His hands. Can we sing that together? I have a maker. I have a maker. He formed my heart. He formed my heart before even time began. Before even time began, my life was in His hands. My life was in His hands. He knows my name. Yes, He does. Yes, He does. He knows my every thought. He sees each tear that falls, and He hears me when I call. Can you sing that with me? He knows my name. He knows my name. Let it be the cry of your heart. He knows my every thought. He knows my every thought. And He sees each tear. He sees each tear that falls. And He hears me. And hears me when I call. Join me and call Him your Father. Jesus taught us one beautiful prayer. And that prayer, the first thing He taught us is to call God our Father. I have a Father. He calls me His own. He calls me His own. He will never leave me. He'll never leave me. No matter where I go, no matter where I go. Can you say He knows my name? Oh, He knows my name.
Can you open your arms and say, He knows my every thought?
And He knows my every thought.
And He sees each tear.
He sees each tear that falls. And He hears me when I call.
Sing this song from your heart and let faith rise tonight. As we sing it, let's sing it with confidence. Maybe our minds are doubtful, but let's make sure deep down in our heart we know that God is our Father and He does not make any mistake. He does not make any mistake. You are here because He has called you. Sing it out.
I have a Maker. He formed my heart.
Say, before even time began.
Before even time began, my life was in His hands.
Can you sing that one more time? I have a Maker.
I have a Maker.
He formed my heart.
He formed my heart. Before even time began, my life was in His hands, oh Lord,
and He knows my name. Can we open our hands up to the heavens and He say, He knows my every thought.
He knows my every thought.
He sees each tear,
and He sees each tear that falls, and He hears me when
hands close to our heart and say, I have a Father.
I have a Father.
He calls me His own.
He calls me His own.
Oh, I know He'll never leave me.
He'll never leave me. No matter me where I call. He hears me where I call, Lord. He hears me where I
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
You may raise your right hand and repeat the prayer after me. Heavenly Father,
Jesus, our Savior.
Holy Spirit, our Comforter.
Holy Spirit, our
Healer.
Our Healer.
our consoler, and our counselor. We praise you.
We adore you.
We worship you.
We love you.
We thank you
for having brought us together
here. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Now the Lord is giving a message that through this Holy Eucharist, the Lord was healing you, and some people who had pain on the foot, those who had pain on the foot, very specially heel, would you please stand up? All those who have pain on the foot, and very specially heel, would you please stand up and lift up both hands? And those who sit also, kindly lift up the hands and say three hallelujah very loudly. Once again, three hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for a miraculous healing. Once again, three hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus, let there be healing. In the name of Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Once again, three hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Once more. Hallelujah. 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 Give a mighty hand to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Those who are healed of that pain on the foot, would you please lift up the hands? Those who are healed, kindly stand up, others sit. And those who are healed of the pain on the foot, kindly come to the front. No. Okay, what happened?
10 years ago, I was standing on a wall and I suddenly felt very dizzy and fell. And my the leg was broken.
Foot?
The ankle.
Ankle?
Yeah, and then I was rushed to the hospital. They operated and pushed back the bone.
But you had pain? But you had pain?
Yes, I had pain. All these
10 years you had pain?
Yeah.
And how is it now?
It's okay now.
No pain? No pain? No pain at all?
No pain at
all. Hallelujah! Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. And?
I've been having spurs on my right foot for the last 8 or 9 months, and I've been taking homeopathic medicine. But each time I sat and got up, it would be difficult. And today I was able to stand and, you know, stand for a long time without pain.
Give a mighty hand to the Lord. Hallelujah.
My left ankle, Father, once when I got up in the morning, it got twisted.
And
now one and a half year.
1.5 years. No pain at all?
Now no pain.
Give your hand to Jesus.
For the past 3 months, I was having the pain in the...
3 months?
3 months
no
in
pain.
The hill.
No pain now
down. I don't find.
Give your hand to Jesus. Let us stand up. Through the Holy Eucharist, the Lord Jesus was healing us. Now let us pray to the Almighty Father that He may send the Holy Spirit upon the whole gathering here and upon the people, those who are waiting at home, those who are expecting our prayer, and pray for them earnestly and fervently that they too may be touched and healed by the Holy Spirit. O Spirit of the living God, come and anoint all of us.
Spirit of the living God, full of fresh oil. Spirit. Full of fresh oil.
Your hands.
Top the living God full of fresh honor. Spirit of the living God full of fresh honor. Spirit of the living God full of fresh honor. Spirit of the living God. Spirit of the living God.
Spirit of the living God,
we all thank.
John's Gospel, chapter 2. John's Gospel, chapter 2, verses 1 to 11. John's Gospel, chapter 2, verses 1 to 11. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So this was a celebration. And of course, we all celebrate the feast or the birthday or anniversary, etc. And one Malayali somewhere near Muringoor or Chalakudi had the same type of celebration for the first communion of his daughter. And when he came to me to invite, I asked him, "Can I believe that you will not serve liquor in this celebration?" He said, "No, Father, I will not serve." I couldn't go for the celebration because I was busy with my ministry. But that evening, when I met a priest who was present there in this celebration, I asked him, "Father, can you give me a message regarding the celebration? I wanted to know whether he served liquor, alcohol, in this celebration." Then he told me, "Father, he did not serve the liquor, but it was available there." Then I was shocked. That night, 11 o'clock, I tried to contact this man. Then I asked him, "Did you serve the liquor?" "No, Father. I had promised you I will not serve." But then I asked, "Brother, why do you fool me? I already heard the news that you were serving liquor." "Then, no, Father, I did not serve. My servants only did that." Then I asked him, "Did you pray before the celebration?" "Yes, Father, I prayed." "What did you pray?" "Jesus, there shall not be rain today." And he expected that Jesus would be standing above the clouds to hold it there without permitting the cloud to come down. Then I asked him, "Jesus could perform that miracle by giving a very good climate. There was no rain, nothing. And did you invite the Lord into your meal, into your celebration?" Then he told me, "Father, usually I pray like this. Jesus, you know that we all need you. But when we are not in need of you, please don't interfere. We will do something which is forbidden as per your law, but we have to celebrate." And then next day he came and told me, "Father, there is only one life in the world. And if I am keeping all the rules and regulations of the retreat preachers, then I will not be able to enjoy the life in this world. Then I asked him, did you take the liquor yesterday, last night? I said, no, Father. I took the liquor. Then I told him, don't say lie to me. Don't lie to me. I am sure that you had the liquor. Father, yesterday I did not take the liquor. I took the liquor after midnight. Today, okay. Yesterday I didn't take the liquor. So somehow he managed to find out a reason to commit a sin. This family, wedding at Cana, they had invited Jesus and the disciples also were present. And Jesus, the Lord, and the disciples, they represent all the saints in heaven now for the time being. Hallelujah. So we have to seek the help of the triune God in the celebrations and also all the saints in heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One lady, she's 33, that's why I said lady. She wanted to join the convent, but her aged father and the sick mother said, we cannot accompany you. If you can go, you have to go to the northern side of India by yourself. We cannot accompany you, but we will pray for you and we will bless you from here. Then this 33 years old lady asked me, Father, is it wrong to travel alone? I said, no. Then, Father, what to do to get a protection from the Almighty Lord, from all the enemies? Then I said, just seek the help of the Almighty God. Let the divine presence be there with you throughout the journey. Second thing, you have to call all the saints to accompany you. And the lady was so faithful to the Lord. She lived 33 years in the world only to protect the family, the mother and father. They were aged and they had no child for 19 years. After that, they got a child. And now this child grew up and she is 33. She is teaching in a school and she wanted to join the convent. Why did she delay? Because she wanted to take care of the parents. If they permit only, she wanted to go to the convent or join the convent. Now, then the parents said, now Jesus is there to protect us. And they attended a retreat with me in the Divine Retreat Center. Then I said, some parents, those who have only one son or one daughter, they are reluctant to send the daughter or son to the seminary or convent, thinking that they will be left alone in their old age. But I can prove to you that even the parents, those who had 5 or 6 or 8 children, they were left alone. For example, a mother who is a widow who had 11 children, 10 are boys and only one girl. She became a nun. And all the other 10 boys, they got their share. And one share for the mother and the nun, the daughter who is in the convent. You know what happened? When she was sick, these 10 boys, those who are now settled, they are grown up people now, nobody turned to the mother to take care of her. They said, we are living in North India, I'm living in UK, I'm living in Australia, how can I take you to that country? If you are ready to come, we are ready to take you, but you are not ready to come. How can we come and stay in the northern part of Kerala? It's a hilly area, and she was alone there. But do you know what happened? That woman is dropped in an aged home and the sisters that take care of her. The nun also comes and taking care of this mother. And there were 11 children for this mother, but nobody was there to take care of her. So this family, which does not have any other support but only the Lord, the father and mother, aged parents, they said, you can go and join the convent. We will never become a stumbling block in your spiritual sojourn. You know what happened? This woman is traveling in the train. She is alone there. somewhere in UP, some people entered this compartment and they wanted to do play some mischief there. Some youngsters, those were drunkards or drug addicts, and they wanted to attack this young woman. And on the way, she prayed only one thing: Jesus, I am going to join the convent and I am sure that you are there with me. You are in my heart. And I need one more help. I need millions of angels from heaven and hundreds and thousands of saints from heaven. And these people tried to molest this woman very many times. And at the end, next day morning, one young man told this woman, there is something special in you. I tried many times to attack you, but whenever I come to you, I see not only you, but so many people around you. And I'm sure this woman was gifted by the Lord, anointed by the Lord. All the heavenly saints were there, angels were there. And whenever we invite the Lord into our family, all the saints will be there. For example, here, they had invited Jesus. Apostles also are there, and Mary also was there. And now, the next point. Mother asked Jesus, or told Jesus, or informed Jesus that their wine is over. Jesus is asking a question to this mother. Why are you concerned about this thing? Is it something related with us or with you? My hour has not come. The Lord, who said the same thing after a few minutes or after 1 hour or 30 minutes or maybe few hours, performed a miracle. And here we had not particular point that Mary is not questioning the statement of Jesus. Mary is going straight to the servants and telling them, do what he is asking you to do. My dear friends, whenever we seek the help of Mother Mary or any saint in heaven, they can intercede for us, they can help us. That they are pleading to the Almighty Jesus for us. And then they are asking us, these saints are asking us, okay, Mary, Jose, first you do what he is asking you to do. Then only Jesus will do what he must do. Hallelujah. And the servants asked, what shall we do? Then Jesus said, fill the jars with water. And there is a special feature for this jars. What was that? It was not jars used to keep the wine. It was only the jars which was used to keep the water there to wash the feet. And Jesus is asking them to fill the jars. They could have asked Jesus something. Jesus, please come to the other room. All the wine jars are kept there. You come there and perform a miracle, not here. This is a totally different thing. But instead of questioning Jesus or asking more clarification, they immediately believed in the word of the Lord and did what Jesus asked them to do. And after filling the jars, they are looking at Jesus. Jesus is turning the water into the wine. And Jesus said, my hour has not come. The same Lord is performing a miracle here. What is the meaning? What's the message? Can you tell me? Yes? Okay, believe one thing. We have to believe in the Lord and obey the Lord. Second, obey the Lord without questioning the Lord. Then, next, we need to be patient. Okay. I noticed something else there. They fill them up to the brim. What is the meaning? That we all know. We all know English. Something else. Yes. What is that?
They give their best.
Whenever we do something according to the will of the Lord, do it maximum. How much we can do, that much we have to do. Hallelujah. One girl is praying to the Lord. The previous night of the examination mathematics, she 11:30 she phoned up and said, Father, I'm so tensed and worried. Tomorrow is the mathematics examination. Would you please pray over me? A Mallu girl asked me. I prayed over her. Mallu means Malayali. Malayali girl. Sorry for that word. Malayali girl asked me, pray over me. I said, I will pray. I prayed over her. Then I told her, now you go and sleep. But the morning, what time you intend to get him? When should I get a father? No, then I said, no, Betty, when are you going to get him? 8 o'clock, father. Why? I want to sleep, father. Now you go and sleep. How many hours you want to sleep? 8 and a half, father. 8 and a half now. Previous night of the exam. I think you can sleep 6 hours maximum. Then you have to go and write the exam. Early morning you get up and study. Father, Jeremiah 32:27 says, I am the Lord God of all human beings. Is there anything impossible with me? Luke 1:37 says, nothing is impossible with the Lord. Luke 18:27 says, what is impossible for man is possible for God. Then why can't God perform a miracle even if I get up at 8 o'clock, Father? Then I said, then you have to read Mark 9:23 also. Those who believe, everything is possible. Do you believe in Jesus? Yes, Father. Then I asked, from where did you get these quotations? From you, Father. When last January I attended your retreat there as a preparation for the examination, you conducted a retreat. I attended your retreat. Then I wrote down these quotations and learned by heart. I said, don't tell me by heart. You kept it in your mind only, not in the heart. Very many people learn the word of God. And they learn and they keep in the mind only, not in the heart. Hallelujah. This word of God must be realized in my life. This girl is expecting a miracle from the Lord, but she's not ready to what she's supposed to do. Hallelujah. And these servants, they never questioned Jesus. They immediately listened to the word of God and obeyed the word of God. My dear friends, Luke 17:11 and the following. Luke 17:10 lepers were healed, but only one leper was saved. Did you notice that? 10 were healed, but only one was saved. How did he get the salvation? Is evaluating. When I got an attraction to Jesus, I went to him. So the first thing is attraction to Jesus. And second, when I went to Jesus, I got a chance to pray. The first is attraction. Second, he went. When I went to Jesus, I got a chance to pray. What was the prayer? Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. Hallelujah. And when I prayed, I got a chance to listen to the word of God. What was the word of God? Go and show yourselves to the priests. When I listened to the word of God, I was blessed to receive it with faith. So first, attraction. Second, going to Jesus, praying to Jesus, then listening to the word of God, then receiving the word of God with faith. And when I received the word of God, I was blessed to obey the word of God. Can you repeat all the steps? Attraction, going to Jesus, praying, listening, receiving the word of God with the faith, obeying the word of God. And when I obeyed the word of God, I was miraculously healed by Jesus and his words. Hallelujah. Then he is taking a resolution. I will again go to Jesus. Again I will pray. Again I will listen to the word of God. And I will receive the word of God with faith. And I will continue obeying the word of God. And I want to continue and grow in my healing. Hallelujah. A person who was totally paralyzed after an accident. He was brought to the Divine Retreat Centre some 3 years ago. Then his wife came and told me, Father, would you please come to the room and pray over my husband? I went to the room, I prayed over him. Then I asked, did you make your confession? Then he told me, Father, I don't remember any sin. I thought it is because of the accident. Then I asked the wife. Has any problem with the memory? Yes, Father, he remembers everything. Then why did he forgive his sins? Because he is not making the examination conscience, the wife told me. Then I gave my book to him. Malayalam, I published a book on examination conscience. All the sins are printed there with the word of God. I gave one copy to him and said, did you see this book? Yeah. Did you go through? No. Why? Because I am paralyzed. Then did you ask your wife to read it out for you? No. Why? When she reads this book, she will look at my face and identify my sin. How? Whenever she reads the sin, then immediately the color of my face will change, you know. I will, then she will find out my sin, that's why. Then can you read it? Father, better not to read it, Father. Why? I'm afraid of facing my sin. Okay. Then I asked the wife, don't look at your husband. You turn to that side and read out these passages for him. Then she did that. I went out. And after 2-3 hours, I came and asked him. I went to his room and asked him, did you listen to all these readings and everything? Yes, Father. And did you find out your sins? Yes, Father. Then I will bring a priest. You can make a confession. The priest came. You know, this man handed over the whole book to him and said, whatever is written there, down there, I have committed. Then the priest told him, this is not confession. You have to confess your sins. Then the man told him, why should you waste your time, Father? The priest came and told me, Father, he doesn't repent. Then I went and asked him, why don't you make your confession? Father, please, it is a time of instant solutions. Why should you waste your time? I committed all the sins. Just absolve me. My dear friends, he doesn't repent. And that evening, that week retreat, Friday, after praying over all the people, again I went to the room. Then he is weeping and weeping and weeping. And I asked, what happened? I'm crying not for, not because of the sickness. I think something is troubling my spirit. What is that? All the sins which I committed against my Lord, my wife, my children, and the church, and others. I'm the worst sinner in the world. Who told you? Somebody is telling me from inside. The Lord convicted him. Then again I called the same priest. You know, from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m., he was confessing his sins. And 4 o'clock, the priest absolved his sins. And then his wife came to my room and said, Father, would you please permit my husband to attend one more retreat? I said, not one, even 2-3 retreats, let him attend. And he agreed. Next week, Tuesday again he confessed. And he was miraculously healed that night during the Mass. He stood up and he came to the stage and testified the healing. But after 6 months again he came. Again his wife came and said, Father, again he is paralyzed. Then I asked her, do you know the problem behind the whole thing? Yes, Father, I know. What is that? He is a drunkard. Not only that, he is selling out liquor. In his village, he is making country liquor. You know that, no? Yeah, country liquor and selling out. And he is manufacturing this liquor. And he is poisoning the people, neighboring people, because in a very wrong manner he is making the liquor. And he is serving the liquor and selling out the liquor. And again he committed a sin. Then when he fell sick, the wife asked him, Father Mathew told you to stop committing sin. Then why did you repeat this sin? Then he said, then the Lord is a merciful God. Why can't he heal me and keep me in my healing even when I commit a sin? Then the wife gave the phone to him. When she reached home, she gave the phone to him and said, speak to Father Mathew. Father, let me ask a simple question. I have my baby in my house, and when he commits a sin, I will continue loving him, I will bless him, and I will support him, even if he is making a mistake. In the same manner, why can't God bless me? Then I said, one boy is playing in the courtyard, in the mud. And mommy said, baby, I'm making ice cream for you. Come with a clean hand, then I will give you ice cream. If the mother is giving this ice cream to the baby, the ice cream the boy is holding in the hand, or the child is holding in the hand with full of mud, then ice cream will become mud cream, isn't it? Mother will never give ice cream to the boy, baby who has got this mud on the hand. In the same way, Lord cannot bless you when you are in sin. Then he told me, Father, this time also tell my Lord to forgive my sin. But when I reach heaven, I will put a petition in front of the Lord. Please stop talking about sin. There is only one thing which is enjoyable in the world, that is sin, he told me. I was shocked. Who told you that sin is only one which is enjoyable? Father, whatever is giving us pleasure, you people are denying it. Don't drink. Don't go for sexual sin. And whatever is giving us pleasure, you are denying it. My dear friends, if I come to the Lord, if I go to the Lord, if somebody is coming to the Lord, then we have to appropriate the mind of the Lord Jesus. And some people are arguing with me, Father, if I am enjoying the sin, then why should you say don't commit sin? A man came to Tabor Divine Retreat Center with a woman and they asked for a room. They claimed that they are husband and wife. Then there was no room available, so I told them there is no room. Anyway, you can attend the retreat. The husband will be in gents section and this wife will be in the woman section. But another man came and told me, Father, they are not married people. Then I asked, how do you know? They are my neighbor's father. They are not married. Then I asked this man, are you married? I am going to get married. Uh-huh. Then why did you ask for a room? Father, we are living together. How can you do that? Then he asked me, what is the problem? You are not married, then how can you live together? Then he told me, Father, we live together. We do everything together. And I am happy, she is happy. Why are you jealous of us, Father? I stopped asking questions to him. Hallelujah. My dear friends, this man who is coming to Jesus with leprosy, he is proving to the Lord and to the whole humanity that all those who receive blessings from the Lord, they have to continue in that blessings. But that will remain there with you only when you are with Jesus. As long as you are with the Lord, the blessings also will be there. Because all the blessings are coming from? All the blessings are coming from? I didn't hear. From? Okay, opposite to blessings, there is something else. What is that? Curse. And curse come from? Satan. Curse is coming from the Satan and blessings are from the Lord. And my dear friends, whenever the Lord is asking us to do something, we have to do maximum. Try your level best to complete it. Then the Lord will do the needful. Second point, after receiving a blessing from the Lord, don't think that you are perfect. You have to grow into that perfection of the Heavenly Father. Matthew 5:48. Be perfect as the Heavenly Father is perfect. That perfection we will be able to attain only after the life, after this earthly life, when we reach heaven. Hallelujah. So my dear friends, today we will take a resolution. We will take a resolution that never we will stop the process of growth in the Lord. I will try to remain with the Lord, and I will continuously follow the instructions given by the Lord, the commandments given by the Lord, and every inspiration given by the Holy Spirit. Sing. Hallelujah, Father. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Spirit.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
We all thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
We all thank you, Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
We adore you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
We adore you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We adore your Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Join your hands and bow to the Lord. Jesus is coming to touch and heal everyone. Whatever sin we committed against the Lord, against His word, against His plan, let us repent. Jesus I pray in your name for this people, and using my priestly authority and joining with the Holy Pope and all the bishops and priests, and seeking the intercession of all the saints in heaven, and with the help of all the angels, I pray for the deliverance of the people here. And in the name of Jesus, I command all the demonic powers to get out of each and everyone here. Get out of every family and community right now. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And I command you, evil spirit, go to the foot of Lord's cross to be bound there forever. Lift up the hands and praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And in the mighty name of Jesus, let the people be delivered from every kind of bondage and infirmity. In the name of Jesus, let there be mighty miracles and healings. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We love you, Father. We praise you, Father. We adore you, Father. We worship you, Father. We adore you, Father. We thank you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Join your hands once again. Bow to the Lord. Repent of all the sins which you committed. Jesus, I beg to you, forgive the sins of all those who are here. Forgive the sins of all the sick. Jesus, you alone can forgive. You alone can forgive now, Jesus. We repent, O Lord. We committed sins against your precepts and statutes, against your plan. We went astray from you, Lord. And now, using my priestly authority, I pray for those who are in the thickest hellish darkness, those who are haunted by the evil spirit, those who are under the bondage of alcoholism, drug addiction, smoking, all those who are with the sexual bad habits, inordinate affections and relationships, people with adulterous mind, and people with the sin of adultery and fornication, and every kind of sexual perversion and aberration, I pray for them that they may be totally delivered and healed right now. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Lift up both hands and say three hallelujah. Once more. Yeshua Namath. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Once more. Yeshua, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Join your hands and repeat this word of God after me. The Gospel of Saint Matthew, chapter 4. Verses 23 and 24. Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing every disease and every infirmity among the people. His fame spread throughout all Syria, and they brought to him all the sick, those afflicted with various diseases and pains, demoniacs, epileptics and paralytics, and he healed them. Hallelujah! 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 The Gospel of Saint Matthew, chapter 8, verses 16 and 17. That evening, they brought to him many who were possessed with the demons, and he cast out the spirits with a word, and he healed all who were sick. This was to fulfill what was spoken by the prophet Isaiah. He took our infirmities and bore our diseases. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! All of you kindly stand up. Hallelujah! 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 The book of Isaiah, chapter 53, verses 5 and 6. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that made us whole. And with his stripes we are healed. Hallelujah! 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 Book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 14. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved. Hallelujah! 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 Book of Jeremiah, chapter 30, verse 17. I will restore them to health and heal their wounds, says the Lord. Lift up both hands and praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for mighty miracles and healings. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In the mighty holy name of Jesus, I pray for mighty miracles and healings. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. 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 Stretch forth right hand towards the Lord and pray. Hallelujah. Jesus,
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 in your holy name,
in your holy name,
I pray for all the sick,
for all the sick,
that they may be healed,
that they may be healed
miraculously,
miraculously,
in your name,
in your name,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
let the sick be healed,
let the sick be healed,
let the broken hearted,
let the broken hearted,
be consoled,
be consoled,
be comforted,
be comforted,
be delivered,
be delivered,
and be healed,
and be healed
right now,
right now,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah,
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 hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for healings and miracles. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You can open your eyes and look at Jesus. You can open your eyes and look at Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Abba, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We love you, Father. We praise you, Father. We worship you, Father. We adore you, Father. Ala barbadil irkadamar bostrudakutuluriya ambari vastradikkathil irkadamar badiliriya ambari badiliriya mallari padulur irkadamar vastradikkathiliriya ambari badiliriya mallari ba hallelujah ambari badiliriya ariyariya hallelujah abar badirikkathilirerere ambari badilirkadamar badilirerere ambari badilirkathilirerere samari badilirkadamar bostrudakutuluriya ambari badilirkadamar badilirerere. Let the sick be healed from every kind of infirmity, cancer, paralysis, leprosy, AIDS, headache, brain problem, eye problem, and ear problem, nose problem, mouth ulcer, throat infection, cold, chest infection, lung problem, lung cancer, pancreatic problems, rheumatoid arthritis, and joints pain, and all the people with a bone problem. Those who are sick with the bone cancer, blood cancer, different types of cancer, people with the pain and agony, people with the swelling, people with the sore on the body, people with the ankle pain, people with the physical ailments and spiritual problems, those who are sleepless, those who have problem with the sleep, all the people with the infirmities of the body, mind and soul, all the people afflicted by evil spirits, I pray for all the sick. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Keep praising the Lord and receive the blessing. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We worship you, we worship you.